हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। आई एम अंकिता भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम सहजानंद इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल एट नाथेज। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्टिविटी 6.6 एंड 6.7, दैट इज बर्निंग ऑफ मैग्नीशियम स्ट्रिप एंड रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन, राइट। So now we will discuss about that is activity 6.8. So students, I will show you one video related to this activity.
How to identify a chemical reaction? Let's perform this activity to understand. Here we have taken some baking soda in a test tube. Add a few drops of vinegar into the test tube with the help of a dropper. The evolved carbon dioxide gas is passed into a test tube containing lime water. Observe the color change. We can see that the lime water turns to milky. It forms calcium carbonate and water. Here, the reaction between carbon dioxide and calcium hydroxide results into formation of calcium carbonate and water. A change in which one or more new substances are formed is called chemical change. A chemical change is also called a chemical reaction.
So in activity, you see that when you add the vinegar, when you add the pinch of baking soda into the vinegar solution, the hissing sound and the bubbles of carbon dioxide is coming out. Right? Now, the freshly prepared lime water add. Got it? Now students, here given the chemical reaction between vinegar and baking soda solution. So when the baking soda added to the vinegar solution, so the carbon dioxide and the other substances are formed in that. Now let us see the chemical formula between vinegar and baking soda. So the chemical equation, the chemical formula of the vinegar acetic acid is CH3COOH. And the baking soda, the chemical name of the baking soda is sodium hydroxide. And the chemical name, the chemical equation is NaHCO3. It formed carbon dioxide and other substances. Now, let us see the reaction between carbon dioxide and lime water. So, when carbon dioxide, the bubbles of carbon dioxide is added into the freshly prepared lime water. At that time, it formed the carbon. It formed the calcium carbonate. Right. So here the chemical equation is given to you. When the carbon dioxide, the chemical formula is CO2, is added into the lime water. So the chemical formula of the lime water is COH twice. It form calcium carbonate, which is CaCO3, right? So from this activity, you can say that this one is the chemical change. You can consider in the chemical change, right? So the definition of the chemical change in that, a change in which one or more new substances are formed is called chemical change, and the chemical change is permanent change. In that, the individual properties cannot be written again. For an example, the burning of iron. So when the coal is burned in the presence of oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide. So when the coal is burned in the presence of oxygen, it forms the carbon dioxide. In this, the only two reactants, carbon and oxygen. So there are the new substances are formed, right? And the individual properties cannot be retained. So, we cannot retain again the coal from that. That's why, right? So, the chemical here, more example is given to you. So, the chemical changes are digestion of food in our human body, ripening of fruits, fermentation of grapes, etc. Right? And it is also in the medicines, chemical reactions is takes place. And also the useful material is plastic and detergents are produced by the chemical reaction. Right? So the every new materials is discovered by the chemical changes. You can say that the one or more new substances are formed in the chemical change. Here also some important points is given to you about chemical change. So the first one in that, heat, light or any other radiation may be given off or absorbed. Second is sound may be produced. Third one is a change in the smell may takes place or a new smell may be give off. And the fourth one is a color change may take place. And the last point in that is a gas may be formed. Now let us discuss this important point one by one. So you saw that the burning of magnesium ribbon is a chemical change. So we already do that activity. The burning of magnesium strip is a chemical change. And the burning of coal and wood or leaves is also a chemical change. I think you observe at your home the burning of wood and coal, right? It's also the chemical change. In fact, burning of any substance is a chemical change. And the burning is always accompanied by the production of heat. It always accompanied by the production of heat. And here is the point is given what? Heat, light or any other radiation may be given off or absorbed. Now see further. Now explosion of firework is chemical change. So the explosion it means we used in Diwali the firecrackers produce heat, light, sound and unpleasant gases that pollute the atmosphere. That's why you are advised not to play with the firework. For the second point, what is that? The second point is a change in smell may take place or a new smell may be give off. So when food gets spoiled, it produces the foul smell, right? So it is also the chemical change, because when the food gets spoiled, at that time the fungi is spread out on the surface of foods. So that's why the foul smell is coming out from that. Now the next point we have, that is a color change may take place. So these are one more chemical change. When your mother cut the apple or potato and if you put for a few minutes at the room temperature and after few minutes you observe that the surface of apple and potato color is changed. It turn in brown or black color. Why? Because here the oxidation reaction will takes place with the atmospheric oxygen, right? So these all are the chemical change. We can say that these all are the chemical change, because in that one or more new substances is formed. Right? So in class 5, in a chapter 5, you learn about the neutralization process. So what is neutralized? When the acid react with the basid, at that time salt and water are formed. So these are the neutralization process. So here question is asked, is neutralization is a chemical change? Why not? Neutralization is a chemical change because new substance is formed, that is salt and water. So in chemical changes, one and more new substances is formed. That's why we can say that the neutralization process is also called the chemical change. Here, protective shield. The one point is given to you about ozone layer. Now let us discuss. So you must have heard of the ozone layer in our atmosphere. It protects us from the harmful ultraviolet radiation which come from the sun. And the ozone absorbs the radiation and break down to the oxygen. And oxygen is the different from ozone. Right? So here oxygen is different from the ozone. When the ozone is react with the diatomic oxygen, and the ozone is formed, that is O3. The chemical formula of the ozone is O3. That is O3. And if ultraviolet radiation were not absorbed by ozone, it would reach the earth's surface and cause harmful to us and the other life forms. So it causes the global warming and the skin disease in human, right? So that's why here the ozone protects us from the ultraviolet radiation, that is natural shields against this radiation. So we can say that it is also useful for us, right? Now the next point we have, that is rusting of iron. We already talked about the rusting of iron. You know very well what is rust. At the layer of brown film of any iron article, it's called rust. And the process of the rust is called rusting, right? So this one change that affect the iron article, you know very well, and slowly destroyed them. So since iron is used in making bridges, ships, cars, truck bodies and the many other articles, and the monetary loss due to the rusting is huge. So there are the huge monetary loss due to the rusting, right? And the process of rusting can be represented by the following equation. Here the chemical equation is given to you about rusting, that is when iron is react with the atmospheric oxygen and the water, that is moisture, it gets rust. You know very well, the rust is the iron oxide, and the chemical formula of the iron oxide is Fe2O3. I already told you. The chemical name of the iron oxide is ferric oxide, right? So for rusting, the presence of both oxygen and water is essential. So for the rusting process, the oxygen and water is required, right? So in fact, if the contact of moisture in air is high, which means if it is more humid, the rusting becomes faster. So you know very well, as compared to desert, in the coastal area, the rusting process is faster, right? So the humid, in the humid weather, the rusting is faster. But here one more question arises. How do we prevent the rusting. So if we are that are the one simple way, apply a coat of paint or a grease, or in fact this coat should be applied regularly to prevent the rusting. And the another way is to deposit a layer of metal like chromium and zinc, where chromium is symbolized with Cr and the zinc which is symbolized with Zn, right? And this process of depositing a layer of zinc and the chromium on iron is called galvanization. And you must observe that the iron pipe we used in our home to carry water are galvanized to prevent the rusting, right? And you know that the sieves are made up of iron, and the part of them remains underwater. The part is the bottom of the sieve, which is also made up of iron, right? And the water drops keeps the cleaning to the sieve's outer surface. And moreover, the water of sea contains many salts, and the salt water makes the process of rust formation faster. So you know very well, in the sea water it contains the salt, or in the salt water the rusting process is very fast. So therefore the sieves suffer a lot of damage from the rusting in spite of being the painting, right? So much that a fraction of sieve iron has to be replaced every year. So to prevent the rusting of sieve body, they use the surface of a magnesium. So they use the magnesium block on the surface of sieve, because magnesium is highly reactive with the iron, and after some time the magnesium block should be replaced, right? So this way we prevent. Now the last point in this chapter, that is crystallization. So students, I will show you one video related to this activity.
Prepare crystals of copper sulfate from an impure sample of copper sulfate solution. The process of formation of solid crystals from a homogeneous solution is called crystallization. It is a physical change. For example, the salt we get from seawater can have many impurities in it. To remove these impurities and obtain pure salt, the process of crystallization is used.
Madam, explain the process of extracting crystals of copper sulfate from an impure sample of copper sulfate solution using method of crystallization.
Let's perform an experiment to prepare crystals of copper sulfate from an impure sample of copper sulfate solution. The materials required are china dish, glass rod, an impure copper sulfate sample, powdered form, concentrated sulfuric acid, Bunsen burner, 250 milliliter beaker, wire gauge, tripod stand, wash bottle and distilled water. Procedure: take a clean beaker, 250 milliliter, and put the powdered impure sample of copper sulfate in it. Add distilled water and stir the contents gently with the help of a glass rod. In order to make the solution more clear, add 2 or 3 drops of concentrated sulfuric acid in it. Stir it continuously and add more impure copper sulfate until no more of it dissolves. Filter the solution and collect the filtrate in a china dish. Place the china dish over wire gauge
kept over a tripod stand and heat it gently. As the solution gets heated, stir it with a glass rod. This helps in uniform evaporation and prevents the formation of a solid crust. Wash the crystals with a thin stream of cold water with the help of a wash bottle. Dry the crystals by pressing them gently between sheets of filter paper. Observation: blue-colored crystals of copper sulfate are formed. Result: the crystals of pure copper sulfate can be obtained from an impure solution.
So in this activity, we observe that after cooling the filtration, we again get back the copper sulfate. Right? So we can say that this one is the physical change, because the properties of copper sulfate is retained again. It is the reversible process. So that's why we can say that it is physical change. So students, our chapter is over here. In this chapter, we learn that the physical change and chemical change. So now you can identify the physical change and the chemical change. So students, our session is over here. Now next video we will upload in next session with the new chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.